Hello. All right, so today we're going to look at apply, which is a really great thing to know about. If you don't know about it, it shouldn't take too long. I'm sure there's more advanced things you could do with it, but just getting your beaks wet, as I like saying it, it's quite easy. So let's start with just talking about why, how could we actually, what does that mean? How could we apply something onto a function? First of all, functions are types of objects, just like almost anything else in Flash, and because functions are types of objects, behind the hood, they have a little bit more functionality, which is two functions which are mostly used, which is apply and call. Now, let's look at a scenario where we could use apply, and we're going to look at at call on a different date. So let's just take a small sample. I created an array, and this array has numbers, and I really want to know the smallest and biggest number. Unfortunately, if I go to my math class, I just try the min or the man or the max. I'll see that it's expecting me to send it parameters as direct parameters, as numbers. And although we have numbers in an array, we can't just send our array inside of our min parameter. We have to have a way around it to be able to call our min function and send it that array as the parameters. Now, fortunately for us, there is a way by using that apply that we've talked about. So by just calling apply, so instead of calling min and opening a bracket, we're going to call apply. And let's look at the two parameters that apply expects. The first parameter that apply expects is the scope of that specific function. Now, as you probably know already, there's two types of functions. There's a function that doesn't have a scope, which is just called a function. And there are functions that do have a scope, which are called methods. And a way to differentiate between them a lot of times is basically a function that belongs to something is a method. Well, a function that doesn't belong to anything is just a function. Now, a method in our scenario, we're not using a method, but if we were using a method, we'd want to make sure that we're keeping the this inside of that object the same. Or if we wanted to, we could have changed the scope. We could have changed the scope by changing the parameter here, which we're not going to look into in this video. In this video, we're going to send null because we're working with a function that is actually a static function, or in other words, it has no scope. Fantastic. So our first parameter was null because our function does not have a scope, and the second parameter is exactly what we hoped. It's actually expecting an array that will have the parameters of the function. So if I place here a and I close the bracket, that's all I had to do to set my function to accept our array instead of accepting numbers. So if I run this function and I just save it for a second and run it, we're going to see that my min value is coming about exactly as I would hope to, which is one is definitely the lowest number. We could try it also with max. And run our application again, we'll see that we're getting 1 and we're getting 99.3, which are definitely all the stuff we would hope to get. Now, obviously, apply you could use in a lot more advanced scenarios. And one of the great things and the dangerous things with apply is that the built-in compiling errors that you would get don't work. So, for example, if I put here just a string, Flash would not detect that there was a string in there, and instead of that, we're going to get some sort of runtime unexpected thing, maybe. Or that value is just not going to be treated the way we'd hope to treat it. So, let's say, for example, put here the value false, and I run it one more time. Now I'm going to get 0, which is what I hope to get because it took my Boolean value of false, converted it to 0, and then we got 0 as our smallest value. Now, obviously, if we were to run our min or max directly, if I would just call math min and send it the value of false, then I would get an error. Well, especially if I don't spell it correctly, I would get an error. All right, so it's telling me we're expecting a number. So basically, by working with apply, the danger in it, which I think is the most fantastic and fun part of it, is that you're avoiding all those compiling errors, and instead of that, you're going to get runtime scenarios, which, if you're comfortable enough, that is definitely the next step you should do, because a lot of times you're going to find, not a lot, but sometimes you're going to find ways to use an apply instead of writing a whole function that creates that finds a minimum or maximum, for example, in our scenario. So why create a new function if all you had to do is just call apply? So I hope this was helpful, and if you enjoy this, please let me know, and if you didn't, please let me know as well. And if you have any questions, concerns, comments, or requests, please feel free to comment in the comment box.